Hey everyone, about to play Mercenaries Playground of Destruction, one of my favorite games of all time, and this is the original Xbox version played on a 360 so we can get better quality. And I'm going to try, well, me and my friend Brett here are going to try to capture all the 52 decks, and we're going to bring them all live. So I played this game many times, and Brett's seen me play it a couple times.
Yes, but this is my first time actually getting into the game. I seen him, glimpse of him playing the game, but we decided that we're going to take the time to catch every 52 card deck. I mean, every 52 members from the card deck. So we're going in hard. And David has been inspired to do this because he hasn't seen any videos on YouTube of anybody claiming to do this. So we want to be the first. Even though the game is kind of old, but the graphics are still amazing to me. I'm still impressed. Even though it's an Xbox One game, it still, to me, it looks like an early 360 game. In my opinion.
Yeah, I mean, it does look pretty good on the Xbox. And playing on the 360, and I know this game crashes a couple of times.
So bear with us.
So it may happen or may not. Maybe that's why no one's recorded all the 52. And yeah, we're bringing them all live. And when you get past, I think, the diamonds, this game gets hard as hell. And maybe that's why no one wants to do it. So we pretty much have to deal with freezing and the difficulty spike. So this could be insanely hard to do. And let's start it off. We're going to play with, Nielsen. He's on the...
I have to read it before you could, just didn't know the guy's name as many times as you played this game.
Nah, because I didn't know if it was Nelson or Nielsen, but it looks like Nielsen.
You gotta have some confidence, man.
Oh, we're gonna capture all of them. Man,
You had an interesting point, David, when you said that movie came out not too long ago called The Interviewer.
Yeah, if anyone remembers that Seth Rogen movie back in November of, I think it was November of 2014. Apparently, you know, it was about North Korea, and they didn't show it in theaters because of our relationship with North Korea, which is weird because this game is all about
killing
North Koreans. And there's also another game called Homefront, which is about North Korea invading America, but no one had a problem with that. And
right, but yet, when it comes to a movie, thanks. Everybody goes okay, crazy. Well,
today when it comes to Seth Rogen, people like lose their
this is an unparalleled
mind.
Financial opportunity for Xbox, but it's high risk. North Korea is a quagmire.
Mind lost.
Mind lost. There you go.
Because of this man here.
So, you know, yes, it's just explaining this force us into a, what you can do. And moral position. This game is great. It has a sequel. And the sequel, in my opinion, is horrible.
Anyone operating in this would be famous.
Maybe.
This kind of, you know, you see, this is like a PowerPoint presentation, and they just tell you that this guy's worth $100 million.
North Korea is in total chaos.
You know, it just kind of gets down to it when you do this, when it shows this beginning, and then, you know, it just shows the game. And the second one kind of did a bad job at the very beginning. But this isn't about the second Mercenaries. This is about the first one, which is amazing. And those are all the factions. We're going to capture all the 52 decks. All the decks of 52. I can never say it right. There they are. The deck of 52.
To sum up, we insert bada a single bing, agent boom. To go after the bounties.
And it's just kind of weird because I brought something to David's attention as many times as he's played this game. I was like, so are the Queens guys or girls?
The AN have never been shy about
yeah,
they're guys.
Yeah, that is weird. Apparently the Queens are dudes. By working with the factions, I wonder if they can make fun of for that.
You know, it's like, it's like you're Jack and it's like kind of like, do I want to rank up to be a Queen?
Got it.
Fiona, I guess I'll go ahead and be a queen, so that way I can have a chance to become king.
Go, but I have one
but
more
I was like,
question.
I wonder, like, in the, within each deck, relying on a you know, clubs, diamonds, hearts, and spades, I wonder in
yes,
each
I
one,
do.
I wonder if they make fun
I
of the queen.
I believe I have the perfect candidate.
Yeah, be like, you're a queen. You're less of a man.
And all right. Or maybe the queen is, like, the hardest one, you know, just to, like, kind of fool everyone. Just be like, yeah, man, you're not going to capture this guy alive. You pretty much got to, like, throw a nuke on this dude to kill him.
True.
And one thing I like about this game is the loading screens. It has a very old school, like, almost PS1 type feeling, you know?
I agree.
Little tidbits. I just really hope it doesn't freeze during this. I did try attempting this, and the play save got corrupted, and I almost got the, I was up until the point where I was about to get the, well, let's listen.
My name's Fiona, your ex-op support coordinator for this mission.
What's the deal? We're almost there yet?
Nice to meet you, too. You're about 10 minutes from the DMZ drop zone.
Good. Waiting is not my thing.
Try meditation. I've heard that helps.
Just get me off this bird.
I was gonna say, I got up to the, what is it? It's the first ones. I can't even think. It was the clubs. Almost got the ace of clubs, and the game froze, and I started.
Look how big technology was back then. It's like, if we got that now, it'd be like half that size.
Yeah, man, if they made a Mercenaries 3, you would probably be pulling like an iPhone 15 out by now or something.
It kills people, right?
Alright.
I know it's not state of the art.
Don't forget the M67. Well, people, right? I love
M67. Hey, I thought you said you never played this. I'm just joking.
Well, this part, remember I said I saw a glimpse, so I saw this cutscene so many times. I love it. And haven't really seen too much of the gameplay, so I am so excited about this.
Yeah, you and me both, you know, I've seen this cutscene way too many times, I can't take it anymore, but let's just hurry up, get in this Hummer here, start playing the game. He's always ready, always.
Always.
I'm always ready.
You know they say the DMZ is the most dangerous place on Earth.
Just wait till I get there.
Easy, boy. Just don't forget about our payday, okay?
Forget the $100 million. Impossible.
It actually took some effort. Look how big that plane is. Big enough to have a car. Walk space.
Not only that, he had to use two hands to pull this lever down. It just felt like... Well, yeah, I mean, it did take effort, like you said, yeah. Alright, let's hop in and get the hell out of this cutscene, because this is hell.
And this was before Fast 7, people.
Yeah.
He was doing this before Fast 7.
Yeah.
Let's do it!
Make like a 50 Cent reference, you know, because it has something to do with Hummers.
And they were just in the sky like 2 seconds ago. So much altitude, no land, and all of a sudden, here you go.
Yeah, all of a sudden, just on the dirt. They got down. They did that quick. Alright, this is Mercenaries, everyone. Again, one of my favorite games.
And they have a Grand Theft Auto 3 reference. Like, if you blow stuff up, you get money.
Yeah, if anyone remembers in GTA 3, if you hit vehicles, you get cash. And, when you blow up, you know, the North Korean Jeeps and stuff, I'm hitting my own vehicle. Well, the guy got in my own vehicle, you get cash. And, I'll show it to you right now. So this is it. You know, you're fighting the North Koreans, you're blowing up stuff. It's amazing. Sometimes you gotta do it twice with these grenades. Bada bing.
4,000. Can you imagine making $4,000 from blowing up a vehicle?
Whoa. Yeah. And, where did that come from? Okay. Yeah, I mean, that'd be awesome if you could just get some cash. Blowing up stuff. It's amazing how my vehicle still, like, survived all this. Even though I just blew up, like, 5 Jeeps around it.
The area is a lot hotter than we expected.
It's pretty much in this game. These are the allies here. This is, like, the first factions. You kill North Koreans in front of them. Progress goes up, or your morale goes up. Yeah, respect. And let's get in a Jeep here. That's what I love about this game. You summon allies. My favorite part of this game. And this game came out, I think, like 5 months after San Andreas. So nobody was really at the time. I know there's like a million GTA. Type open world games, but to have like a military GTA type game like so close to, like, you know, after San Andreas was released, I thought that was pretty crazy that they did something like this. Still one of my favorite games, even though the sequel sucks. I'm going to talk about that a lot because it was really disappointing. And I'm driving all over the place, and I just hit a chain, and I just need to go straight.
Holy, free holy. The mercenary.
I mean, the introduction is great. You know, like your base is getting all attacked.
I just want you to explain to me why we're still getting the crap chilled out of us. And I don't want to hear the word.
And it's funny how this guy doesn't notice. You know, I'm just staring at him.
Now, who the hell is this?
Reminds me of the guy from Halo 2, like, you know, the sergeant.
Yeah.
It's like they got the same, like, voice actor or something at the time.
They're like, he's black, so we need the same guy.
Didn't this come out before Halo 2? I don't even know. Halo 2 came out in 2004. This game came out, like, in early 2005, I think.
All right, we'll give it a shot. Stop that artillery, verify the two clubs, and maybe we can do business together.
Yeah, man, you know. They're like, hey, you sound like him. Put you in the game.
And one last thing. Don't you ever interrupt me again.
All right, we're just gonna go in there.
How come they don't make a huge screen? I always wondered that. Like, you saw how they were looking at a map of screens? It's like they have to put up six screens just to look at the whole map. Why can't they just make one big screen?
All right, I guess that was before, like, LCDs were really, like, cheap. But then again, they're using six, so I don't get it either, man. I mean, that's where our military money goes.
Let's roll.
Plasma TVs. It's great. Alright, so right now we're going after the two of clubs.
You would think... Oh, yeah, the two, okay. Because the aces are technically the one, but that's the top, so...
Yeah, that's after you do, like, all the missions for all the factions. So, I'm just going to skip ahead of these people, just speed things up, because we got a long way to go, and the difficulty is going to spike, and we're just probably going to be just extremely aggravating trying to capture all these people, but we're doing it. There it is.
And he has a rocket launcher. Dang.
And he ran away, too.
He can run away?
Nah, normally in the cutscene, he, like, stands there. That time he ran away. Even the fucking Club of Two is getting tired of seeing this shit.
Damn.
It looks like they're trying to kill the dude. Like, whoa. Oh my god. That was close. I do not feel like starting this over again. He's only killing the dude.
Excellent. He's not going anywhere. Now we call for an AN extraction helicopter.
Oh my goodness. There we go. Alright, so right now we're gonna extract him. If you never play Mercenaries, this is what you gotta do. Get him out of the battle zone. Deliver him.
Cutscene for picking him up.
Get this cool cutscene for picking him up.
Go pick up the two and carry him to the helicopter.
There we go. First capture, everyone.
Woohoo!
Got 51 more to go.
Well, that wasn't too bad. We did that within 15 minutes. So, what's 15 times 52?
It's gonna be a lot more than 52 minutes. I mean, 15 plus 52, I don't know, probably like 17 hours. Alright, so I'm calling in this airstrike here.
Before,
if I had an RPG, I'd just shoot it from here to speed things up, but I'm just showing, you know, airstrikes you do. Is there an RPG around here? Here we go, we got this little weapon crate here.
This is before Gears of War, Hammer of Judgment.
I think it's the Hammer of Dawn.
Oh.
But, you know, I know what you meant. Damn. Only just takes one. There you go, see? Don't even need this strike. You know, to save time, you know, you just hop in here. Yeah, you know? Don't shoot. We're gonna do this epic. We're gonna do this epic. We're gonna do this stupid. Okay, they didn't explode. Alright, that was. Alright, that was anticlimactic. Well, whatever.
Wow, what a mess. They really needed your help.
Man.
Killing your own man.
I'm surprised. He's all right. I think he disappeared, but, you know,
I'm surprised your morale didn't go down.
I know, right? God damn.
How much did you get? 25,000?
And that's it.
20,000. So you already almost have $100,000 15 minutes into the game.
$20,000.
So that means you that lets you know that everything you buy in this game is expensive.
Probably everything you buy in this game is extremely expensive.
It's probably like $2,000 per bullet.
I'm surprised they didn't go that route, but yeah, you know. And there's your eight screens. They got like a grid in the way. It could just be one giant screen. Okay, that's what you meant. Yeah, I don't get it. Bring me enough intel, I'll get you that clearance. Speaking of which, you'll want to talk to the man leading. All right, yeah, man. So that's
Oh wait, you forgot the fish.
We'll have plenty of time for fish. And that's the main dude, man. It's probably gonna be like 10 hours to capture this guy, but whatever. You know, we're gonna go after him. We're gonna go in hard. Gonna capture him. Probably gonna like rage quit 1,000 times, but it's gonna happen. We're gonna get it on film, and we're capturing Song, man.
Could you imagine being a part of a group? Like, it's like if you want to get in, you got to start at one of the number two card on one of the.
I know, right? That ranking thing's weird. It's like, you know.
It's like, could you imagine being a part of 52 people?
And then you're like the queen, you know. And that's weird about this game is there's no autosave, so gotta remember just to constantly save. And you know, sometimes you get progress, and if this game freezes, which I hope it doesn't do, we're gonna just, you know, start here. We got some extra other saves, yeah. But yeah, that was the Two of Clubs, and get ready to see some more capturing, you know, and some more missions and stuff.
And there's a bunch of mini games.
Yeah, you can also, you know, arrest citizens and not have any penalties, which I love doing.
Can you get money for arresting them?
No.
Can you take the handcuffs off of them?
No. And then look, he disappeared.
That's what they do in real life, people. When you get arrested, you disappear.